Iso FX. I think we started making these in 2018. So the mixers came in 2016, which was Radius 2 and then Radius 4. And then Andy and I, we just wanted to create great esoteric audio products. Quite quickly, we decided, look, we want to create a really beautiful esoteric effects unit, which is using the understanding of all the classic, beautifully made, beautiful sounding effects units of yesteryear, coupled with how we want to produce it for a performance aspect of DJing. And yeah, FX was born. So FX essentially works in two ways. You've got the top section, which integrates perfectly with our send and return system on our DJ mixers. So per channel sends, increase the send, you can hear the effect. And then crucially, the bottom section, which enables a global filter system on our DJ mixers. So the two work in conjunction. They not only sound amazing, but they give like a huge creative freedom to how you play music. Coming from the left, you've got the time signature, so that basically has the delay of time in whichever effect you use. Then moving along here, there are eight effects, so you've got three delays, three reverbs, auto BPM delay on eight now, and a modulation effect to number seven. So instead of cramming our products full of things that people probably won't use, we decided to really go in and think, how would the user use modulation of delay, modulation of reverb? And I think we've absolutely nailed the way that this thing works. It, sound is so open, it's bodied. It's got so much control over the artist and how they can use it. It's almost like it's like an instrument, you know? So it's really easy to set up, really easy to get into, but it also keeps giving back over time. So I find it really important that audio products you should fall in love with, and you should really get to understand them. And with effects, that's certainly something that you can get to know over a period of time, with different music, with different styles, even with different places, you know, playing different venues and things like that. We wanted this unit to be not overtake the music, but to really complement it. But there's also a lot of power in it, so you can really show your creative force at home, or even in a festival or in a club or wherever. So it's something that we're ultra proud of, that we've created such a unique product for DJs, and the adaptability into different things as well. So starting off really simple with the filter section on our mixers. So I'll throw a house record in, like a nice deep house record. So what I want to do is I want to create dynamic in this record, and I want to show you how the filter section with the distortion and the way it works, you can produce from beautiful natural sweeps to more aggressive style filters. So starting off first, I've moved the resonance knob around a little bit. So I want to create a dynamic within the sweep of the filter. So I've got this distortion down, engage the filter. So there, you're dropping that bottom end out. You've got a little bit of resonance in the sound. You're able to throw it back in. So that works really well within an environment where you want to create some push and pull within the record. Naturally it has filters, naturally it has delays and reverbs within the sound. But what we're trying to do here is we're trying to create some more added effect to make you completely unique in how you use your performance, really. So I've tried the high pass filter there. Let's go into the low pass. So essentially, now I'm creating a slow sweep in the low pass. So I can create, so going right down there and coming back out, which is great. Then if I move on to the band pass, you press them both at the same time. So what the band pass will do is it'll create a band in the frequency. So essentially there, so you can create it up and down. You can move the resonance around and create more of a natural sound. Go on, come back out. So straight back in. What I tend to really like to do is punch the filters in and out, and then maybe sweep it back. So that's really cool. So if I want to punch a low pass in, so I'll drop the sound out. You know, so you're straight back in, or you can punch it out and then sweep it back in. If you want it to sound more natural, just change the resonance a bit really. So then it's much more natural. Throwing it back in, you can even switch between onto bandpass, switch the resonance. So it's all kind of done on the fly. So there's no right or wrong thing to do with it. It's just, depending on what the type of music that you're playing, you might want to be really natural with the sound, or you might want to be quite aggressive. And that's a real joy of being able to understand how this effect, how the filtration unit works and how to get the best out of it. Now, touching on the distortion section, works when the filter section's engaged. So what I'll do now is I'll just pop the high pass filter on. I'll bring that distortion section in. So you can start to hear it now. So what, that's crunching up the sound. It's making it sound really granular and grainy. If you push the distortion low, the side chain will come on. And then you can turn it on and off. There. You know, you can use it over bars of music. It works really good with like techno-y stuff. So you can use it there. You know, when you can cut it in and out. Obviously, it'll turn it off when you turn the filter off. Then you cut, say if you want to cut it in now. Oh, heavy. So you can turn it on and off, which is great. So remember, we're only using the filter section here, so we haven't started using the effects section. So I just want to show you how effective it is in creating filter sweeps, creating punches, creating natural filters, or creating quite a heavy rhythm, depending on what style of music you want to play. Like I say, I've chosen like a deep house record for this one because it just showcases everything, but you use it with any style of music really. Again, just throw it in. You can almost adjust the resonance on the fly as well. So you might want it sounding more natural, then as you bring it up, you might want to create that rhythm there, create that cue in the filter, drop it back in and out again. Add some distortion as you're coming down there. So that's the side chain and out again. So there's so many ways to be able to create your own sound with the filter, and naturally it just sounds great. It just gives you so much scope globally. So essentially there, drop that in, back out, and at the end of a track, you know, at the end of a set, maybe you want to start to filter it all out, so then you're fading out and fade the track out, you know, to finish off at the end of a night or whatever. So moving on to the effects section now. Effects one is a stereo pitch delay. So if I just put like a dubby kind of record on, which has got some space in it, so moving the time section there, so if I pull up the auxiliary, you can hear it, just to create some lovely effect to the sound. So we're not overtaking the sound, so the pitch there is enabling me to move the time signature around. It's enabling me to just jump in and out there, which sounds amazing. So if I just drop that out on the channel, you can hear the delay just moving around there. I can also bring it down here. The filter section here enables you to actually filter the delay section, so I can filter all the sound out to high pass, or I can bring the whole of the filter mix in there, which sounds amazing. Now this parameter section gives the length of the delay. So essentially I could keep it there and start bringing it in if I want. I could bring it out. Remember, the auxiliary section brings this in and out of the mixer. There, so it just sounds beautiful. So you can drop it in and out like that. I mean, it just sounds beautiful. And then the pitch, drop it back in with the pitch. Changing the signature, making it sound offbeat, onbeat, it's just lovely. Making it phase, bringing the filter in and out. So it really is like an instrument. So you're almost overdubbing. Well, you are overdubbing the record. So essentially now I'll just drop the whole mix out and the pitch just brings the whole mix out. Just great. So FX2 is a mono delay with high pass filter. And as it's unpitched, I find that it works really well with more live music, so say disco records and things, and I use it and I really think it works amazing on the end of phrases and just to add a little bit of texture to the end of a bar or something like that, so it's not overtaking the music, it's a massive addition to it. I'll just pop a disco record on and I'll just show you. So maybe at the end of a vocal snippet or something. So essentially if we get to the end of a So you just throw it in at the end of a phrase, or you can just throw it in at the end of a vocal snippet. Keep the delay quite short. So you're throwing it in there. So you're just doubling up on that beat there. So keeping it a half note, a quarter note, letting the vocal play itself around. And then at the end of this phrase here, so you're just letting it flow, and essentially, I think that's what FX2 is perfect for. So moving on to FX3, it's similar to FX1 in that it's a pitch delay, but at the end of the delay trail, there is a reverb, so it kind of gives like a metallic-y feel to the end of the trail, which is fantastic. I'll just pop a kind of a dub record on, really, a kind of a dubby thing, and I find it really works so well. So you can kind of, you can hear it there, and as you bring the delay back down, so it opens up that delay space on the timing here, so that's 3/4, so it's kind of working with that rhythm. So, because it's pitched, and now what I'll do is I'll just drop that out so you can hear. You hear the noise on the end. And again, you can pitch it up. What I kind of like doing on things like this is on the end of a phrase. So kind of phase it there, and then drop it. And you can hear the noise coming out. So loads of fun. Have lots of fun with it, and yeah, that's FX3. So FX4, 5 and 6 are reverbs. Really important in all types of music that you're creating space. So FX4 is essentially a general purpose reverb. So let me just put more of an electronic record on and just create some space within the record. So if I bring it in like this, what you kind of do is on here with the timing, essentially the timing is the minimum is very short, the maximum is longer, and it just works on time signatures. So essentially if I bring in the auxiliary here, keep that filter down, you're creating a reverb there, it's very short. So if I bring in that timing there, I'll just drop it out so you can hear the reverb trail, so that it's creating a bigger reverb now. Just let that bar run around, and I'll drop it out now. So you can hear there, so it trails. There's a real depth to that reverb. It sounds great. Don't forget you can alter how deep that reverb goes in the mix with the low and the high with the filter. So essentially it's a high pass. So I'll put it in a little bit higher there, bring in the reverb again. So you'll just hear the high. So you're bringing it in there. You can hear it coming over the mix, creating a load of space and dropping it out now. So it's creating a higher. You can even filter it in and out. So if I drop it back in there, you can hear all the bottom end in it. If I pull all that filter out, just hear the high end, then you can hear it all drift away, which is just beautiful. So lots of fun, lots and lots and lots of playability with the reverb sections. So that's reverb 4. So reverb 5, we've called it the bass reverb with a huge low end response. So what better records to put on than kind of caliber DRS, Mark and Estes records, which are amazingly produced. So I want to create some space inside those records and making it our own. So if we'll just sort of putting these records on, and they're just huge and expansive, and the production's amazing. So essentially what I want to do is create even more depth to it. So if I throw some depth in there, hear it drop in and out there. Or even there, if I'm producing, I'm just adding textures and adding layers. So that's tight now, so I can add a smaller reverb to it. Hear it there, just at the end there. Add some more filter to that reverb and then bring it in over time. So essentially there, it's creating a load of low-end response. I can even hide that on the filter there and just keep dropping it in. So bring it in over time. So what I'll do now is I'll just bring the whole of the mix in there so I can just show you. But essentially at the end of the phrase here, and you feel that, it's just huge. So on a big system, the depth, the clarity, the body of the reverb is just amazing. So again here, I can just feel that it'll work perfectly. So you're creating more of a texture underneath that. There you go, so there it is. Again, just dropping away, straight back in. Loads of fun, have lots of fun with it, and that's FX5. So FX number 6 is another reverb, but with an adjustable gate. So when I'm using sort of reverbs on tight drums, you can really hear the gate, but then if you open it up, you can create a lot of space within the mix. I'll just kind of put a drum workout on so you can hear it. So I'll bring this quite tight now, so you can kind of, so that's kind of a tight gate there. So you can kind of hear it being on the gate. Now I'll leave the auxiliary open. So now I'm gonna create some more space. So you can really hear that reverb now coming in. There, it's creating now. So if you've got a breakdown in the track, this is great to create some space. But if I drop this out halfway between, you'll be able to hear that reverb really doing its work. There. So now it's creating a big open space, and then throw it back in. So that's a great way of using FX6 as a short gated style reverb when you want to produce something nice and punchy, nice and tight, or then using the time function to open it up and create some space, possibly in the breakdown. FX6 is the one you want to use. So FX7 is a completely unique effect. It's a gated and delayed noise. So what I tend to do with this is, and I tend to find people use it as, it's almost like a dreamlike effect. So it creates some extra rhythmic music or rhythmic effect within the music. Works really well on music that's very full, so that's drum and bass records, or maybe even full disco records, or things with a lot of movement in them. So essentially, it's essentially the same. You bring up the auxiliary, so you can hear it in the mix, and then you start to play around with the filter frequency and the time. So here, there, you're creating the movement, and it's really an effect that you can use over maybe 8 or 16 bars, so it's a really performance filter effect. So you can hear it there on the filter. So I'm putting a high pass in, I'm putting all the filter in there of the low pass now, and I'm making it move around in the track, and it works really well over time. So it's about creating your own little groove within the groove. So you hear it there, the gate and the noise working together, creating a sweep really, which is just beautiful. So over 8 bars, 16 bars, whatever you like, or use it even more sparingly if you like, but this is what this has kind of been designed for, just create that noise, gated noise effect, and a sweeping effect, which is just great. So So our second generation of FX unit now features auto BPM on FX8. So it's a mono delay with auto BPM. It's easy to tell when the auto BPM is on FX8 because the sidechain will flash green to indicate the beat. So I'll put a machine driven. So if you see straight away, it's detected the beat on there. So I've put it on a half note at the moment. So I'll bring up the auxiliary send there. And it's already detected the beat. I'll just drop that note out now, or drop the track out so you can hear it dropping away. So it's dropping away on a half note. So I'll just throw that back in and put it on a quarter note. So again, it's detected the beat. I'll just drop it in so you can hear there, it's on a quarter note. So it's tighter. I'll finish off on 1/1. So essentially then the delay will be on the beat. So there you go. So sort of machine driven funk. It's on the beat. So that's a great way for someone who is playing around with effects 1, 2, and 3. And they're using their own style to move it around. But then sometimes you want to put a machine-driven track on track 8 and use the funk of the machine to create the groove, then FX8 is perfect.